guys, your boy Crippers, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Hester Low Career Mode, where last time I left off. Gamvola, I made a pro league history by becoming the top goal scorer in the history of its existence by scoring his 42nd goal of the season. And I put in another great performance. All credit really must go to Nikolic, who once again absolutely bossed it. But if you saw the last video, you'll know that his run of being the only player to score in the cup competition did indeed end. Someone else scored. So, Romans scored two goals, actually. Two of the six goals I ended up scoring. Their four goals, of course, did come from Nikolic.
Well, we've got a great game for you today.
Puts his tally on.
Is with me. We're both really looking forward to describing it for you. Coming up is Bruges against Vestalo.
I think we've got a great game on our hands here, Martin. First versus
15. 15. He was on 11 at the start.
With some wonderful
match ending.
Might just see a bit more.
Oh, wait, that's 15. My bad. He could have scored 5 goals, but I decided to reward Romans with letting him take the second.
Well, he really could be the star of the show.
Yeah,
today.
I got two penalties.
And it's really difficult to get it off him because his body strength
match.
Is
in the excellent. Last episode. The second leg will be in between this match and the next match, the next league game, but since I'm 6-0 up, I think I can comfortably say, you know what, I can
front three with a central striker.
No bother. I shouldn't have any issues.
On the flanks.
I'd be very disappointed.
Complicated job, actually, because they've got to come in.
He's got his shot off now. The goalkeeper with a textbook save.
So,
keeps the ball in his tackle here.
Unless something goes catastrophically wrong, I should already be
keep it on the pitch. It's gone out for a throw.
In the final. Well, who are we playing? I don't know. I haven't really been paying any kind of attention to the
Timmy Simons
brackets
in the news because
that they have for each competition.
I mean, only he knows when it's right. He might be feeling his body. But, you know, you need to think long and hard before making such a big decision.
Maybe I'll look at that if I get a chance. Maybe, or maybe it'll show it to me after after I send the second leg. That's a possibility too. That could easily happen.
On the attack here. You can't put them in front. Well, they've broken through here with a really good
gamble. That instantly showing that. The breaking the record isn't
going
to slow him down.
And what a finish.
As he slots home goal number 43. Including this game, there are still 10 games remaining. Plus, whatever we have to endure for the freaking playoffs. So Gamvola might do something even Ronaldo and Mane couldn't do, despite the fact that Ronaldo did come close on his 2-4.
He might be through.
Could Gamvola become the first 50 man, first man to score half a century of goals? I mean, 43 goals now. He's on 7 away.
And it's going to be a throw here.
If he will definitely get there. Or even if he was to take a few games off.
Winners the last time
these two teams he met, could still get there with a few braces, hat-trick or two. Isn't in the same
stadium. No, and quite an intimidating atmosphere here. The crowd anxious not to see a repeat, so it will be tough for them.
We could see some real history here.
And now the shot! Fine save he's made there.
In what remains of this season. Come on, win the ball back.
This referee's got a good perception of when and when not to play the advantage. He's chosen to play it here. Trying to find a way through here. And that will be a free kick.
Oh, of course that's a foul. Simons is going to take it, the free kick for Bruges. And header. Or don't. They go out for the goal kick.
Izquierdo. Timmy Simons. Good forward play from them. Crisp defending there. Well, this is how this team play can play sustained attacking football. But when they lose it, as they've done now, it's just a risk that they might get caught out.
They've opened them up here. Well, he scored.
Scores the goal that puts me 2-0 up. That's just what the
dangerous one. We'll see.
Just what the team needed right before the break. Look at that, 14th minute and the 41st minute. For an obsession with the number, there's 4-1.
Intercepting. Onto the attack now.
I joke, of course, that's a complete coincidence.
It was nicely worked until that point when it broke down. Now they've got to try and regain possession. 3 minutes, that's what's going to be played for added time. Here's a chance to attack.
Canola.
That's how to tackle.
Alcosta got the ball, but then he lost it easily.
Half time. Scoreline is 2-0.
I mean, is it too much to ask that your players keep hold of the ball?
Westerlo start the second half.
Like, do I have to have my finger over the contain button at every particular moment?
This is the name of the game at the moment.
Because, I mean, if I do none of my whole hold out all the time, that'll get freaking stupid. Escanvola makes it 3-0.
And that was that team at their very best.
Which,
the defenders seem to lose the
concentration. But finishes off.
They saw it coming from a long way out.
Westerlo.
Marks for the way he lost his marker there. Good movement in the box.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead. Izquierdo.
Affirm. He made an interesting remark to me.
Good, this move.
About my fact that before Ronaldo, no one had scored 40-plus goals for me. He's a head that happens all the time.
Shots on here. Terrific stop.
But wait.
Touch off the defender.
He was thinking in terms of in all competitions, where I said, no, it's I'm talking about league goals.
Goals
in the league. Of course, I've had players score 40 goals for me. In all competitions, especially ones who get 30 plus goals in the league. Hell, I've had players pass 50 in all competitions in the season. But that doesn't.
4-0.
When I say hey, players who've reached 40 is only 3 players,
to make the change now as
it's only
as possible,
3 players team. Because those 3 players scored 40 plus goals in the league.
A lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they still got the ball.
And he gives it back.
The cup goals.
Good defending.
Are a separate. It's right. Game.
He's coming forward with some danger. And here's the shot. He's kept it out. Now it's a corner.
I'd have to do some thinking about what my record is in that, but it can't be that high considering most cup competitions are rather short.
And heads it towards goal.
Mostly I rotate when it comes to cup competitions.
Well, this is a real shock. You can see it in the faces of the players. And you can hear it in the lack of noise, if you like, from the supporters.
Well, those fans can't even be bothered to give their players.
Even back before I didn't need to. I like to just keep players fit. I like to keep the players who weren't always in the first team happy by, giving them some
all
chances to impress. Using the cup competitions, where it be
Leo Rafailov.
The English cups like the FA Cup and the League Cup, or the European competitions like the Champions League and the Europa League. Similar to what I do when I have games in those thing itself.
Possession to the opposition now.
Since I started YouTube, I should say.
It's good balance to him.
He's got his shot off now. What a... Oh, that's a fantastic goal.
We can't really blame the keeper.
And then, normally, most 9 times out of 10, I'll play the first team, the regular starting team, in the final. That's what I normally do.
The game underway again.
Like I said, 9 times out of 10, that's how I'll do it. Sometimes I'll, if the second team has impressed me throughout the season, or if I feel like, it could be a help to them, I'll let them do it sometimes. But more times than not, I'll send out the
came in with the challenge.
First team, because at that point I've normally won the league.
Substitution here for the home side.
Unless the team chasing me is stubborn for that.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in the situation.
So willing to drop points to make sure I would win the league sooner rather than later.
Opportunity to change the tactics as well as the.
But that's. In case anyone else was confused about that.
They've scored from the restart.
I mean, you guys can go back and look at some of the stats from previous scrimmages I've done on here. And you can see players have reached 40 goals. But that's in all competitions. So. I don't know if I needed to clear that up, but I just felt like, better just clear it up in case anyone is confused and has made that same mistake. I mean, I can understand. You're right. But you weren't looking at it the same way I was. If you have made a mistake. It's not anything bad. No one's gonna clear you
good defending.
Stupid or denounce what you say for any particular reason. I'm certainly not gonna do that. In a way you are right. But you may just a small mistake if you were thinking that because you weren't looking at it the same way I was. If that makes sense.
It's a headed effort at goal. He's made the save.
I would hope that makes sense. I try my best to make sense. Doesn't always happen. Sometimes I can just sound like I'm saying garbled gibberish. that's okay. No big deal. Send this, do this training quick. Martin goes up to a 62 rated. It's good. Would have liked some other, some of the R players in the training session to go up as well, but hey, you can't always have what you want. Switch over to the second team. Oh wait. There's the other semi-final. It's Mechelen and Oostien. It's 2-1, so it's close. So no guarantees of who's gonna win that tie. But despite the result, it was always gonna be me who wins this tie. Even with the red card, a missed penalty, no idea why Mass took it. Wait, why did Mass take it? They took Nikolic off after half an hour. Good going there, game. He's only scored 15 goals in the cup competition, and is by far going to get the top goal, top assists in the competition. But yeah, he didn't need to play that game, I suppose, or he didn't need to finish it anyway. You fucking imbeciles! Really? The Wales job. Why am I being offered the Wales job? I guess doing that second email wasn't important. Anyway, on to Genk. I assume the final will be close to the end of the season. And by the end of the season, I mean probably it'll be close to when the league is over. So the next few episodes are probably just going to be mostly the final whole bunch of league games. I would imagine.
Hi there, everybody. Martin Tyler here with you. Alan Smith alongside me. Belgian football, the Belgian Pro League action for you today.
Pleasure to be here, Martin.
And the match today, Westerlo against Genk.
Now you've got your chance to check on the lineup for the home team.
I'm having a thought.
You put them in front. So close.
About
post.
Well, we're getting to the point now, Martin, where
about it right now.
Beginning to see the table really take shape, and these two teams.
And he's headed it goalwards.
The I could.
Has led to that effort at goal, which wasn't far away.
Wasn't far away, and they did well to engineer a few yards of space there.
I mean, that'll get really repetitive. Like, you guys have already patiently sat through a lot of league.
Well, we should really expect some goals
games
today. We're looking at a
to,
home side that shots on here.
That's get to
well,
the point
well
where you can see some cup action.
And your view on the attempt at goal.
I might simulate. Or simulate slash playoff screen those let's be honest, they're meaningless games. I've been qualified to finish in the top six for a while now.
Challenge and the ball broke free.
So, and if this were a normal league, I would already have the league won because I'm so far ahead of game.
Only he knows.
When he gets second place.
He might be feeling his body. But, you know, you need to think long and hard before making such a big decision.
They spread it out wide here. Chance to get some width into this attack. Good play, but they've lost the ball now, and the opposition could get at them.
No guarantee, but I might do that. I might. You have to think about it a bit more before I make
some potential in this move
for certain decision.
To take the lead. That's a great finish for the first goal of the day.
Nivola scores another goal to put me 1-0 up against Genk. I mean,
it was a great race, a great pace, and a fantastic goal.
Oh, how quickly did they go from back to front there? What a counter-attack.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
If I do that, you guys might miss
the home team
reaching
the cards here, it seems.
Goal of 50.
Especially the points that they got for winning the away game on the goal.
And
here's the shot.
He might miss him.
Here comes the cross.
Reaching.
He's got his block in and the cross.
And now
the
shot. Historically,
well, you've got to compliment him for
reaching
trying,
$50
well off target.
In the league season. Sure, I can always tell you guys about that in the next episode.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition, now they're here. And he's got the ball away from him with the tackle. It was nicely worked until that point when it broke down. And now they've got to try and regain possession. Turnover there that we didn't expect. This home team have been unconquerable, home or away. Massive run that they're on, and just want to keep it going today.
Well, you look throughout the side, and it's full of top-class performance, and full of players just exuding confidence.
Sure. If I did that, there would still be however many games I have to play in the playoffs.
It's a wasted throw. He's putting it straight to the opposition.
Before the league is even finished.
That's
so it's not like you'd miss
the goalkeeper.
Any important games.
Giving the ball away.
They've
got the ball back. The interceptor got it.
I don't want to just finish these pointless league games.
There's good progress with this attack. There's the ball in. Defender to it first. Oh, it's a penalty.
As the referee awards a penalty.
At the moment.
Yeah, it's just got worse.
Tends to go 2-0 up just before the halftime interval.
Oh, hats off to the keeper. Shots on here.
DM's
fine moment.
Didn't score her from the initial penalty, but he scored the rebound. And it's 2-0 anyway.
Well, a little look of celebration.
Just
but
on the 40th minute.
Brilliant. Well, sometimes, as a defender, you need a bit of luck. But the
DMs.
He fell at the feet of the man on the spot, the scorer.
Restarting at 2-0. Tackle here. Attacking now. Real chance. Great stop. Good chunk of added time here. 3 minutes.
Gimbola. Is there one more her goal before the break? Upo! Oh.
It will
fantastic goal save from the gamekeeper. Initial save, and then boom, he just freaking palmed it. to make sure it didn't go anywhere near his goal.
And it's a headed effort at goal.
Ooh. That would have been a bit of a kick to the dick out of you had I scored from that corner, to be honest. But hey. It's a...
Half time now.
The miracle of...
The score at the break.
Corners.
Well, they've shown that they can score. We know that they can do that, but it's still plenty in the game as we reach half time.
They've got so many avenues from which they can score. And...
Now you've got your chance to check on the lineup for the home team. To put them in front. There's some potential in this move.
To take the lead.
That's a great finish for the first goal of the day. The home team with all the cards here.
And here's the shot. And the goalkeeper plunged to make the save.
I might go insane before this video ends. You probably noticed I went quiet there for a second because I'm just listening to my dog bark and bark.
I'm in with a challenge.
If I didn't think it would be animal cruelty, I would literally kill him.
Well, this attack
is pissing me off.
Menace to it.
I know dogs are supposed to bark. Aren't they supposed to bark if something is wrong or something like that?
Back into play. Corner given.
That was close. Like the keeper freaking jumping up like he's freaking Superman. And no, you're not scoring. Another goal. Oh. Come on, Boyans, take it back. Oh, Alpo! If you were just a little bit taller, you would have connected with that. It doesn't matter. He's offside, for fuck's sake.
I'm
seriously gonna shout at that dog when this video is over, or unless there is a very good reason he is barking so consistently and so loudly.
Excellent play to lose his marker.
I'm just thankful you guys can't hear it. At least I don't think you guys can hear it.
Well, we're 2/3 of the way through the 90 minutes, half an hour to go. Couple of teammates who are clearly on the same wavelength. Good strong tackle.
My main goal is to get a third goal just to wrap this game up. Oh, there we go.
What a good way to score. Down low and
3-0.
Neatly done. Well, that's put them further in front and nicely taken.
Thank you very much indeed.
Be heading for a comfortable lead here.
Well, here's the goal again. Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
Strömberg is well behind, isn't he? Considering he's just about to reach 30.
Good forward play from them. Patience is the name of the game at the moment. Comes in strongly.
I remember playing FIFA.
In this competition.
Excuse me. I remember when I played FIFA when I was very young. The first time I had a player score 30 goals. Was in a season, I was so happy. I said, like, so amazing. That's like never been done before because kick. I was young. I didn't know do any better. But yeah, when a player reached 30, I was freaking treating it like it was the biggest thing that had ever happened.
Time ticking on. Just over 15 minutes to go. There's some potential in this move. There'll be a signal here.
Oh, that was a very pointless corner to give away. There from Genk's point of view.
He's got his shot off now. Good block. Oh, it's a back heel, easy on the eye, but rather easy for the opposition. Well, he's caught offside, trying to get in behind. He'll say that the pass should have come a bit earlier.
Yeah, he's unlucky. There wasn't
offside
much in it.
Again.
Referee's pointing for a goal kick.
Header.
There's the interception. It's a quick break.
Fiennes. What a ball to Alpo.
Shots on here.
Top corner for 4-0. So that is how you score your 30th goal. Easy.
What a goal.
Well, he's doubled up here with his second goal. And he took it in excellent style, just like the first one.
Rocket it into the top of the net.
So they're looking for 4-0.
Perfectly. Wraps up all 3 points.
Free kick given.
Well, they were already wrapped up at 3-0.
It's very late in the day here.
But 4-0 is just that extra cushion. Because we all need that extra cushion just for a bit more comfort.
The added time is 4 minutes. And here's the shot. Oh, he had a real go.
Well, you can't.
I would have been pissed off if that had gone in.
Just couldn't. Provide the finishing touch.
Well, they're in a good position here.
Alpo! Oh, imagine if he scored the hat trick there.
Getting set at the corner.
That would have been some goal. But, saved by the palm of the hand of the Genk goalkeeper.
And he's up for the header!
Bayern's can only header it straight to said Genk goalkeeper. And there's the full-time whistle. Well, that perfectly ends another episode very well. I mean, it just further proves that playing through the remainder of the games. I mean, look, I'm 30 points ahead of Genk. There is no reason to play the last. To play a playoffs when I'm 30 points ahead of the nearest team to me with 4 games remaining. And I think I said there was more games earlier. I keep thinking there's like 34 games in this for some reason. I keep mixing it up. My bad. But no, indeed there is only 4 games remaining in the whole season. And for some reason I have to play playoffs to win the league, even though I've already comfortably won it. Makes perfect sense, doesn't it? No is the answer, just in case anyone was confused. It's 100% no. So, yeah. I'm probably gonna finish off the season off camera, and when we resume in the next episode, I'll be playing the final of the cup and getting ready to start the playoffs. The completely unnecessary, but are gonna happen anyway, I guess, playoffs. So, yeah. Until next time, hope you all enjoyed this video. Oh, smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new to this channel. Oh, click on the bell so you are notified when a new video goes live. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.